students, we have been given two problems here to form the partial differential equation by eliminating the arbitrary constants from z is equal to a into x power n plus b into y power n. In this first problem, let you take the given equation as equation number 1. Now procedurally, we shall differentiate the given equation number 1 with respect to x. That is dou z by dou x is equal to a is a constant and the differentiation of x power n is n into x power n minus 1. And the differentiation of the next term is 0 because the differentiation of constant is 0. B is a constant, y power n is a constant, 0. And dou z by dou x can be written as per notation it is P, which is equal to a into n into x power n minus 1. From this we can find out a value for a, because we are going to eliminate a and b. A is equal to p divided by n into x power n minus 1. Let this be equation number 2. And next, differentiating with respect to y, it is dou z by dou y is equal to, the differentiation of the first term is 0 because a is a constant, x power n is a constant. When we differentiate with respect to y, the differentiation of the first term is 0 plus b into, we are now differentiating with respect to y, it is n into y power n minus 1, and this is written as q equal to, because dou z by dou y is q equal to b into n into y power n minus 1. From this we can find out a substitution for b, which is equal to q divided by n into y power n minus 1. Now let this be equation number 3. Now we have to form the partial differential equation by eliminating the arbitrary constants. We are having a substitution for a and a substitution for b. Substituting equation 2 and 3 in 1, we get Now substituting 2 and 3 in 1, we get z is equal to, instead of a, we are substituting p divided by n into x power n minus 1 into x power n, plus instead of b, we are substituting q divided by n into y power n minus 1 into y power n. And when we reduce this equation, this will become p divided by n into x, because when you move the x power n minus 1 to the numerator, n will become negative, 1 will become positive, and n will get cancelled each other, and the remainder x. Similarly, q by n into y, and cross multiplying this equation, n into z, n into z, which is equal to px plus it is cross multiplying the equation, we get n into z is equal to px plus qy. This is the required partial differential equation. This one is the required partial differential equation. And looking to the problem, we are first differentiating with respect to x and with respect to y, and we are getting the corresponding differentiation and finding out the substitution for b. These two substitutions are taken as equation number 2 and 3, and substituting 2 and 3 in 1, we get an equation, and finally reducing that equation, we are getting the required partial differential equation.